For so long, I struggled to find the right foods for a weight loss journey. I was always constantly hungry and constantly craving. No healthy foods could ever keep me full, and I thought I'd never be able to go on a weight loss journey because of this. I used to watch so many other people's what I eat in a day for inspiration, but none of them started off as the same body type as me. So I thought I'd never be able to eat what they eat and lose weight, until I finally found a method that would allow me to stop snacking and craving continuously to get to my goal. Hello Daily Student family, welcome back to another video. I hope you're all doing well. I hope you're all doing good, and if you're new here, hello, my name's Kimberly, and I hope you subscribe. Turn your bell notifications on to get notified every single time that I upload. Don't forget to come over and follow my inspirational fitness page on Instagram, as well as my podcast page as well. Now, as you guys can tell from the title of today's video, we are going to be talking all about food. Now, this is so important, as a lot of you guys ask for what I eat a day for my 56-pound weight loss journey, and I thought, you know what's really important first is to give you what foods really helped me. Now, to really break it down to you, I had a massive appetite going into my weight loss journey, a huge appetite, and that was a huge contributing factor as to why I couldn't lose weight, because I'd get to 3 days and not be able to, you know, maintain this new way of eating that I was doing, or I'd just get so hungry by 6 p.m. at night that the whole day of healthy eating was ruined, because by 6 p.m. or 11 p.m. at night, I was just craving snacks, food, anything, and it got to the point where I was just always hungry. I'm like, how can someone always be hungry? And why does my body never adjust to a new way of healthy eating, even if I am eating loads and loads of healthy food? So if that's the type of scenario you're in, or feel like you're frustrated at how hungry you are and always craving, these are some foods that really helped me suppress my hunger. I knew in order to get to my journey, it wasn't about suppressing my hunger and finding things that would allow me to stay satisfied and stay full. And these are the exact things that really helped me do that and helped me with my craving days and regulating my hunger levels. And I'm going to go into every single food item in this video. Now, my number one food is eggs. Now, you guys know I absolutely love eggs. I recently, ages ago, tried the egg diet, which was a crazy diet, which I probably wouldn't be able to ever do again, but it's crazy and fascinating diet. However, there's a reason why eggs are so good and that are used in the egg diet, even though I don't recommend fad diets. Eggs on their own as a snack are really good for suppressing your hunger and your cravings. The reason for this is A, it's a source of protein, and it's known that people who eat protein are going to lose 30% more weight in their weight loss journey. So not only is it a really good fact of protein, increasing your daily protein, but also it's about 60 calories or just under 60 calories per egg. So if you imagine if you get a bit hungry after lunchtime, you want an egg, that's only 60 calories and it's really filling. You can have it in an omelette, you can have it as a boiled egg, you can have it, you know, with loads of different things that on the side of a lunch, on the side of a dinner, that's a bit extra to help you stay full, and they are so low calories, but also giving you something that's really, really essential, i.e. protein. Tip number two is soup. Now, initially when I heard about people doing soups in their diets and their weight loss journeys and that really, really helped them, I was like, ugh. I'm just not a soup person in the slightest. The reason for this is it just doesn't fill me up. But hear me out on this concept that really changed everything for me. Now, because your stomach is literally a fist size, when you're consuming a lot of water, especially foods with high amounts of water, which is why watermelon is so recommended, especially in a weight loss journey because of its water percentage content, having a lot of water allows your stomach to fill up to even halfway or over halfway, to the point where by the time you eat your food, your body has already registered a sense of fullness because of how heavy and how much of the water is filling your stomach. If you think about it, when you want to eat your favorite meal, you think, let me hold off on the drink because I'm going to fill up before I can even finish the good bits. So it works in the same way. So guys, this video was kindly sponsored by Thrive. Have you ever had it when you have a friend or someone who can eat whatever they want and never seem to gain weight? They always seem to stay fit. And sometimes the reason for that can actually be found in their gut bacteria. And I'll tell you exactly why. Good bacteria is related to a lean body weight, and bad bacteria can be a huge contribution for actual weight gain. In the United States alone, over 70 million Americans struggle with gut health issues because of their diet. Too many refined sugars, too many artificial colours, antibiotics, and hormone-filled fried foods are actually contributing to the deterioration of our gut health. So thankfully, there is a way to fix this, and that is better diet and the right probiotics. Thrive makes this really possible by offering you at-home gut health tests to test and see which bacteria will help you with your weight loss journey, will help you with that, to give you an insight of what foods are specific to you to help you lose weight. You could have been eating all the wrong foods, foods for your weight loss journey this whole time, and this test will really help you work that out. They ship a test kit to you in a discreet packaging. Once you take your results, you submit your package and return it to Thrive in a prepaid label packaging. Thrive's accredited team will then receive your results and analyze them to tailor make your probiotics personally for you. Probiotics are not one size fits all. I mean, almost nothing is one size fits all. Like the probiotics you might find in your health store or the nearest health store near you, that's one size fits all. This is tailor made for you. It's really, really important differentiation. These are personalized based on your results from your tests. It gets better. They provide you with a personalized food plan based on your results and based on what you should be eating. For example, when I did mine, they warded me off certain foods that I had been eating for so long. Those foods can actually be what's causing, you know, struggles in weight loss, struggles in always gaining weight. Now guys, there's a 50% discount code linked down in the description, so don't forget to click on the link below if you would like your very own Thrive probiotics and a gut bacteria test. If I'm feeling a bit hungry, what I'll do is I'll eat a huge bowl of soup. Bearing in mind, soups probably only come up to, what, 20 calories? Depending on which one you get, sometimes tops 50. And by having a massive bowl of soup, what you've done is you've consumed so much water within the soup, so flavoursome, it's a little snack, bear in mind. Then you wait 20 minutes. By that point, you're so full. The next food you will have seen in every girl's breakfast, and that is avocados. Now, avocados are absolutely fantastic. I know they're eaten all over the world for breakfast because of that reason, and it's because of how high they are in fiber and good fats. Now, it's important that you know about good fats because A, it's really good for your digestive process in order to lose weight, which is why people will eat a lot of nuts and avocado in a weight loss journey, but also the high content of fiber means it's going to digest really well. When you think about the different types of foods that don't digest well, you've seen how a McDonald's can literally survive forever without even changing its form or shape, without rotting or anything like that, as opposed to avocado. It's gonna break down and go through your body really quickly. You don't want the food to be piling up, and avocado is fantastic for that. And also, because of its high fat content, even though it's good fats, is going to keep you full, and it kept me full for so long, so many times. And I eventually moved up from having half an avocado to having a whole avocado and different blends like that in a salad, and so many other ways to have avocado, which is fantastic for your journey to keep it up and keep it spicy. The next food are apples. Now, this is an amazing phenomenon because it actually goes back into the macros of the apples, which is why it's such a good food to help you stay full. And you know, if you want a snack, if you have a craving, to suppress it with apples. Now, apples again have a huge content of water as well as fiber. Now, not only does fiber help generate the digestive processes, which helps everything move out of your body, that you can start to see results because you're using foods that are helping you push everything out that are organic and good for you, but also the large water content. And it's known that people who eat apples or people who've had apples regularly in their weight loss journey have a higher percentage of having cravings suppressed using apples than any other food. And I've really, really found this because I'm so known for on the go, just grabbing an apple because I know at some point in the day I'm going to want a snack, I'm going to want to eat something. Apple can really quench that hunger. Even at your hungriest, an apple can really do something to quench it before you get an opportunity to get your next meal. So next food are bananas. Now, bananas used to be some of my favorite foods because they're so filling. Now, you've seen that athletes eat a lot of porridge, a lot of bananas, because they are that slow release carbohydrate. And a lot of meals, the reason why I always emphasize how important it is to have carbohydrates is because carbohydrates keep you full. They're just thicker, heavier types of food that are more likely to keep you full. There are two different types of carbohydrates, and I would just say the good and bad carbohydrates. Even though nothing is good and bad, let's just label them for the sake of understanding good and bad carbohydrates. The bad carbohydrates is what you'll find in McDonald's or Chinese, which is gonna make you hungry within the hour, gonna make you hungry maybe even within half an hour. The good carbohydrates are the slow release porridge, bananas that athletes might use because it goes into the body a lot slower and the sugar levels don't spike, which means you can have a more successful, less snacking day if you're having the good carbohydrates because it's not raising and lowering your sugar levels. So banana is good for that exact reason. The good carbohydrate content is going to be a slow release, and that slow release is important because it means it's keeping you fuller because it's releasing slower. The faster something's going in, the more likely you're going to be hungry again. So bananas were fantastic for me whenever it came to a snack, whenever it came to adding it into a meal, adding it into a salad, whether it's fruit salad, whether it's pancakes on breakfast, which is why I say, in fact, pancakes are something amazing to have for breakfast, because when you've got the banana on top, when you've got the oats within the pancake mixture, you're having such a heavy, filling breakfast, and someone who might eat that is probably more likely to have steam to go on for longer in the day than someone who has something really light and sugary or high in anything else. So bananas are fantastic, and I use them as a holy grail for snacking and suppressing my hunger. Now guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Now these foods have been the holy grail and fantastic snacking foods for me for that hunger suppressing and keeping myself full all day long. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a massive thumbs up. Turn your bell notifications on to get notified every single time that I upload. Give it a massive thumbs up if you want more food related videos and workout related videos. Now I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Bye guys.